We are always so quick to point fingers and blame others for the bad things that happen to us in life. However, the expression, "the enemy of a man is himself," is what holds valid for us. The worst part is that we usually don't recognize that it is even happening, so we don't channel our efforts in the things that can make a difference in our lives. In this video, I will share with you 9 ways you are sabotaging yourself. 1. You allow toxic people into your life. Although it's normal to feel guilty about removing toxic people from your life, that doesn't mean it's unnecessary to do that from time to time. Many times you stick to poisonous people not because you are not aware of the negativity they bring into your life, but because you don't want to hurt them, or you are scared that you will be lonely if you let them go. But the more you keep them in your life, the more harm you cause yourself. Don't make room for people who cause you pain, belittle your ideas, or make you feel inadequate about yourself. If someone shows in their actions they are willing to change, then consider keeping them around. But if they continue to show a disregard for your feelings, then it may be time to let go. Letting toxic people go is not an act of cruelty, but rather self-care, as their stay will make your life toxic. 2. You think everyone is out to get you. Do you always feel suspicious about the actions of others? Do you see yourself always questioning people's motives? Then you probably are sabotaging yourself with that thinking. The idea that every correction is an attempt to condemn your actions is a wrong mindset. When you have that kind of mentality, your brain is hardwired to collect information, data, and evidence, and always playing defensive. Even without being asked, you are looking for evidence and data to prove a point. People with this mindset are never able to learn and make corrections. When other people try to point out certain general things, they feel attacked and assume that they are hated. It begins with taking things personally and then assigning harmful intent to the unintentional actions of others, followed by the other hurtful feelings like anger, low self-esteem, etc. 3. You always look to others for approval. From the moment we are born, we are told what to do, what is right versus what is wrong, what success looks like, and the list goes on. It's okay to seek answers in certain situations, but as a whole, it is not out of place to listen and take the counsel of others. However, honoring your own beliefs and thinking for yourself is an important skill and muscle to grow. Many individuals never grow up. Even in adulthood, they act like overgrown babies who sit and eat only when they are asked to. When you stop doing what everybody else wants you to do and start following your intuition, you will find precisely what you're looking for. A person who continually banks on others' approval before taking action is not truly living, but only existing. 4. You view life as a win or lose. Many individuals do not like to see things in a win-win way. They believe it is either a gain or a loss. Although some areas of life may be outrightly defined as per win or lose, like sports, perceiving everyone as an opponent is not an excellent way to live. In life, you are not in a competition with anyone. The earlier you understand it, the better your life will turn out to be. In life, there is always someone smarter, prettier, and taller. So, instead of competing against what others may have or may not have, focus on improving yesterday's version of yourself. An anonymous person once said, "If you compete with everyone else, you will become bitter. If you compete with a previous version of yourself, you will become better." The only person you compete with is yourself, and the game is win or learn. 5. You try to please everyone else. A clear sign that you're self-sabotaging your life is when you compromise yourself for the sake of pleasing others, as a way to feel good about yourself. In this way, you stop focusing on being who you are and only try to be who others want you to be. No matter how hard you try, you cannot please everyone, and no matter how good you are, not everyone will like you. So, you are probably wasting your time and resources and sabotaging yourself by being all things to everyone, except yourself. Indeed, there is the part of making sacrifices for others, especially those happy. But this should not become a habit. if not for every other reason, but for the fact that these same people may take your kindness for granted and end up manipulating you. 6. Your fear of rejection is holding you back. Here is an illustration of two friends, Joe and Jack. Joe is the super talented perfectionist who would rather keep to himself than step out and not get accepted. Jack, on the other hand, has a lower IQ than Joe, but is ever ready to learn and give things a try. An offer comes by. Joe astutely submits his presentation but refuses to show up for fear that it was not good enough. He would not be able to face the shame of rejection. Jack goes for it with the little knowledge he has, prepared to accept whatever the outcome is. After critical examination, Joe's presentation was the best among the others. But where is Joe? Joe is in his comfort zone, his bedroom that never rejects him. Since Joe was nowhere to be found, Jack, who was available, gets his slot. Wait, don't be too quick to cast a stone on Joe. You are most likely guilty as well. Think of the numerous times you have refrained from submitting that proposal, reaching out to that professional, or even answering a potential business call because of your fears. Just like Joe, your fear of rejection is sabotaging your life big time. 7. You don't have goals. This is like the most significant sabotage among all. Going through life without a goal is like embarking on a journey without a destination. Goal setting is a critical aspect of life. It is one of the crucial factors that distinguishes the poor from the rich. It is the first step to greatness. When you don't set goals for your life is dependent on the flow of a river you can't control. The direction is always the same, and you don't get to say where you are headed. However, when you have a goal, instead of staying in the river, you go to the margin of that river. It is not just enough to have dreams, fantasies, and wishes. It would help if you had a plan to pursue the idea. Make the vision understandable and turn those wishes to SMART goals. SMART is the acronym for specific, measurable, achievable, and relevant, and time-based. 8. Not being present. If you find that your mind is racing a mile a minute and dwelling on the past, then chances are you are not in the present moment. You can't change yesterday, so stop trying. But you can ruin today by worrying about tomorrow. Be present. Tomorrow will reveal itself exactly as it should, just as yesterday already has. That's how it's supposed to be. Today is a gift. That's why they call it the present. Being present does not only have professional benefits, it also allows you to think clearly about situations and make wise decisions. In the words of the Russian writer Leo Tolstoy, there is only one critical time, now. It is the most critical time because it is the only time that we have any power. 9. You have analysis paralysis. I guess the anonymous individual who coined out the statement, "too much of everything is bad," referred to extremely critical individuals. How many times have you missed opportunities simply because you are making unending analysis? In life, we most often regret the chances we didn't take than the ones we considered but did not yield desired returns. Waiting for the ducks to line up can sometimes take a lifetime, if at all. Indeed, it is only right to do the appropriate research before making decisions. Sometimes, leaping is better than no choice at all. Often, what we call being analytical is indecisiveness. Indecisiveness delays the inevitable, while taking a chance can teach you how to make better decisions and grows your confidence. Worrying about how things might go wrong doesn't help things to go right. Make do with the facts in your hands and make your decision. Self-sabotage is a significant obstacle in life. If you wish to be happy in life, you must detect those self-sabotaging red flags and deal with them.